B'siyata d'shmaya, we're going to learn Sukkah Daf Yud. We're going to start from the Mishnah, 7 lines from the bottom of Daf Yud Omid Aleph. Says the Mishnah, Pireis Oleo Sadin, if somebody spread out a sheet on top of the schach, Mipnei Achamo, to protect him from the sun, Oy Tachteo, or underneath the schach, Mipnei Anashor, because of the falling leaves, that they shouldn't disturb him in the Sukkah, or he spread a sheet over a kinoif, which a kinoif is a four-posted bed, psula is parcel, because you're not just exclusively under the schach, you're under a sheet. A sheet is parcel schach. However, if you spread a sheet over a two-posted bed, then it's kosher, and the four-posted bed has a post in each corner, and the sheet on top of it acts as a roofing, and therefore it's possible. However, on a naklite amita, on a two-posted bed, then you just have one upright post in the center of the head and foot of the bed, and then you have draped over the top, over a bar going across the two posts, you have draped down a sheet, then the top comes to a point, it's not a roofing, and therefore it's not considered a roof on top of him, and therefore it's kosher. Says the Gemara, Omer of Chizda, lo yishanu elu mepnei anashar. The only reason that if you spread this sheet under the schach in order to collect the leaves that are falling down, it's possible, it's only because the reason you put the sheet there was to collect the leaves. Avlo no'isa. But if you put the sheet there in order to decorate the sukkah, psula, the kshera, in that case, it is kosher, because in that case, it's not called a schach. A schach is a covering. A covering is there to serve to, that the purpose is that it should cover you and be on top of your head for whatever reason. However, when it's there just to decorate the sukkah, it's not there as a covering. It's not considered a schach. It's just there as a decoration. If it's not considered a covering, it's not considered a schach, and therefore it's not posel. That's what Rav Chisda maintained. Says the Gemara, Pshita, Mipnei Anashor Tanan. What are you, Rav Chisda, coming to impress on us? The Mishnah says that if you put a sheet under the schach, and it says explicitly, Mipnei Anashor, that the reason it's possible is because you're putting it there in order to collect the leaves. It should be a covering over you. The Mishnah makes it clear that that's the reason, and therefore it's possible. So what are you, Rav Chisda, coming to teach us? That if it's not put there, Mipnei Anashor, it's put there as a decoration, that it's kosher. Says the Gemara, Ma'udu Teima Hu Adin Dafilu L'Na'isa. I may have thought that the Mishnah indeed is telling us that if you put it there, Mipnei Anashor, it's possible. But I may have thought that the Mishnah is not coming to exclude it putting the covering there, spreading the sheet in order to be a decoration. V'haydik Toni Mipnei Anashor. And the only reason that the Mishnah singled out that the sheet is there to collect the leaves is Urcha de Milsek Toni, because the Mishnah is just telling us what was common practice, and it was more common to put a sheet under a schach to collect the leaves than to decorate the room. Kumash Malonsor of Chiz is coming to say, no. When the Mishnah mentioned Mipnei Anashor, it was only because it's Mipnei Anashor, and indeed, if you put it there as a decoration, it will be kosher. Says the Gemara Lema Masiyeli, we're going to try and bring proof to this opinion from a Braisa. If you put schach on the sukkah, as you should a regular schach, v'itra, and you decorated it, bikromim, with colored curtains, ubasadin in amutziorim, and embroidered linen, v'tolobo, egoizim, and you hang on the schach, nuts, shkedim, almonds, afarsikim, peaches, rimoinim, pomegranates, parchile, anovim, clusters of grapes, v'itra, shel shibolim, and wreaths of grain, yenois, different wines, shmonim, oils, saltois, fine flowers, osur, listapik, mehem. You're not allowed to use from any of these things that you hung on the sukkah. You're not allowed to use them over sukkahs. Ad motzi yom tov achrin, until the motzi yom tov, until the end of Shmini Atzeres or Simchas Torah, whatever you call it, but until the end of the last day of Yom Tov Shel Chag. However, says the Braisa, if at the onset of Yom Tov, or before the onset of Yom Tov, you make a condition, a Tanai, and you say, Eini Boidel Mehem, Kol Bein Ashmoshes, and you say, I don't intend to separate myself from these decorations, and I intend to be allowed to use these decorations over Yom Tov, Hakei Lefi Atanai, the Tanai is valid, and there's a lot of discussion in the Mefarashim exactly when the Tanai works and how the Tanai works, why it works, but that's what the Braisa says. But either way, what did we see in the Braisa? In the Braisa we saw that if you have Sichacha Kilchasa V'itra, and you decorated the Sukkah with Sadinim Amutsuyarim, with embroidered linens, and we assume at this point that these linens were spread under the Schach as a decoration, and we see clearly that the Sukkah is kosher. You're just not allowed to use the decorations over Sukkahs, but the Sukkah in and of its own is kosher. So you have proof from this Braisa to Rav Chisda. Answers, or says the Gemara, no, you don't have proof. Dilma minatzad. It could be that the type of decorations we're talking about here, the type of embroidered linens that are decorating the Sukkah, is on the side, the width of the Sukkah, not on top. And therefore, since it's not covering over the person, you have no proof from this Braisa to what Rav Chisda said, that if you have a sheet which is there exclusively for decorative purposes, that it does not passel the Sukkah. Itma, we learned, noi Sukkah, ein mematim basukkah, the decorations in the Sukkah, the sheets under the schach that are there exclusively for decorative purposes, they do not minimize the size of the Sukkah, which means that what determines the height of the Sukkah, either as being too high, if the schach is 20 amos above the ground, or being just high enough, if the schach is 10 tfochim off the ground, then that doesn't change just because you put a sheet to decorate the schach underneath it. If the schach was too high, then the sheet underneath it, even though the sheet which is decorating the sukkah is within 20 amos, that will not make the sukkah kosher. And if you have schach which is 10 tfochim off the ground, and you put a sheet to decorate it within 10 tvachim off the ground, that does not determine that the sukkah is too low and it is kosher. Because since at the end of the day, these decorations, they're not material of schach, they're not real schach, and therefore they do not determine the height of the sukkah. Omer Vashi, uminatzad mematim, however, on the sides of the sukkah, where you have to be able to fit into the sukkah and have 7 tvachim to fit a person's head, most of his body, and part of a table, at least a tefach of a table, and if the decorations on the side minimize the size of the sukkah, then the sukkah will become posel. Continues the Gemara, Menimin avde de Rav Ashi. Rav Ashi had a servant called Menimin, and it misha le ktointa b'mayo, his shirt got soaked in water, v'shtatcha metalalto, and he spread it out on top of the sukkah. Omer le, Rav Ashi said to him, Dalio, lift it off the sukkah. Deloy lemer, people shouldn't think, komisach b'dova mekabel tumah. It's true that you didn't put it there for the sake of being a schach. You just put it there in order for it to dry. And since you put it there not to be a schach, it's not considered a schach, and therefore it will not be posel. But other people who see it might think that you're using it as schach, and it cannot be schach because it's a dovra mekabel tumah. Anything that's susceptible to becoming tumah is not able to be used for schach. So asks the Gemara of Okachozile Derativo, or it could be that the servant asked Rav Ashi, but everyone can see that it's wet and that I've obviously put it there just to dry and not to be used as schach. Says Rav Ashi, L'chiyav shoka minelecha, that I told you just that once it's dry, then people will no longer be able to see that the reason it's put there is in order to dry it out. People may think that you're putting it there in order to use it as schach, and therefore, as soon as it's dry, take it off the sukkah. Continues the Gemara, Itmar, Noi sukkah. These sheets that were spread under the schach to decorate the sukkah, hamuflogin mimeno arbo, if they are separated, if they are distanced from the schach, they're below the schach, 4 tfachim or more, Rav Nachman Omar Ksheira, Rav Nachman says, since at the end of the day they are a decoration for the sukkah, they are bottle to the sukkah, and it's just considered as being bottle to the schach, and therefore it's kosher. Rav Chisda, Rabbi Baravuna Omri, they say that psula, since it's so far away from the schach, it's not bottle to the schach, and therefore it's just another roofing. It's a roofing which happens not to be kosher schach, and all it means is that you're actually not sitting in a sukkah, you're sitting under a different oihel, you're sitting in a different tent, you're not sitting inside the sukkah, and therefore it's possible. Continues the Gemara, These same Rav Chisda of Rabbi Bar Rav Huna, who said that if you've got the sheets that are four tefachim or more away from the schach, that they are not bottled to the schach, and it's as if you're not sleeping in the sukkah or sitting in the sukkah, they were iklu'u, they were visiting the Beir Esh Galusa, the head of the Galus, the Resh Galusa. Agninu Rav Nachman, who was in charge of the home of the Resh Galusa, he was the Av Beis Din, and he told Rav Chisda and Rabbi Bar Rav Huna that they should sleep in this sukkah. And he told them to sleep in the type of sukkah that Agninu Rav Nachman besukkah shenoya muflogin mimen arba tefachim. That sukkah where Rav Nachman told Rav Chisda and Rabbi Bar Rav Huna to go to, they had a sheet that was hanging more than four tefachim away from the schach. Ishtiku, and they didn't respond. They were just silent. They went, they obediently went there and slept there. They didn't say anything to Rav Nachman. They didn't say to Rav Nachman, just a minute, this is possible, we cannot sleep here. So Rav Nachman said to them, to Rav Chisda and to Rabbi Bar Rav Huna, Hodur Buhu Rabbonon Mishmatayu. You rabbis, have you changed your opinion? Have you changed your mind? Did you not hold that such a sukkah is possible? Omrule, they said to him, Anan Shluchim Mitzvah Anan. We're actually on the way to going to visit the head of the Golus, the Resh Galusa, and there's a mitzvah to be mekabel pnei raboi beregel, and since we're shluchei mitzvah, we're on the way to a mitzvah, we're potter from any other mitzvah. And if we would go looking for a more appropriate sukkah, then it would cost us our ability to do the mitzvah of seeing the Rebbe, and therefore pturin min asukkah, we're actually exempt from sukkah, so it doesn't matter where you put us. Continues the Gemara. And now we're going to discuss the concept that we already saw a little bit in the Mishnah, that we have a kilo or a kinoifois, which are different types of four-posted beds, canopies, which means that you've got four posts, one in each corner of the bed, draped over the top as a roof is a canopy, is a sheet. That's a kilo or a kinoifois. We're also going to discuss a kilas chasanim, a bridal bed, or naklitin, which also has a sheet draped, a canopy draped over it, but they are with two posts. As we said before, there's one post in the middle of the head of the bed, one post in the middle of the foot of the bed, a post going across the two, and then draped over it, coming to a point at the top, there was this sheet, there was this canopy, and that's what we're going to discuss now in the coming Gemara. Omer of Yudam HaShmuel, it was said in the name of Shmuel, Mutter Lishon Bekilo Besukkah, Aval Pi Sheyesh Lo Gag. One's allowed to sleep in the sukkah under such a canopy, even though it's a four-posted canopy, which means that there's a roof, is at least tefach wide roofing, horizontal roofing, on top of him. And nonetheless, it's kosher, he's allowed to sleep in the sukkah. But there's one condition, that the space till the canopy is not 10 tefachim. If it's not 10 tefachim, it's not considered an oihel, an entity of its own. So it's not considered as if he's sleeping in there, it's considered as if he's sleeping in the sukkah. And the fact that he's got this covering over him doesn't take away from the fact that in actual fact he's in the sukkah and it's kosher. And now we're going to ask from five sources against this. The first one, Toshima. Hayoshon bekilo basuka lo yotzo yidei chayvosoi. We know that it says mefurush that if somebody sleeps inside a kilo, inside a four-posted canopy, inside a sukkah, he's not yotzo the mitzvah of sukkah. And this seems to be exactly the opposite of what Shmuel said. Hachab mayaskinon answers the Gemara, or Shmuel will answer, kusha gavoya asoro. We're talking about where the canopy was 10 tefachim high. It was 10 tefachim above the bed, and therefore it's considered an entity of its own, and therefore it's possible. But if there's less than 10 tefachim, that's when Shmuel said that it's okay. Ask the Gemara another question. Eisvei, hayoshon tachas amito. We're going to learn about this on Daf Chof Amud Beis. If somebody sleeps under the bed, besukkah in a sukkah, lo yotzo yidei chayvosoi. He was not yotzo the mitzvah of sukkah. Here again, sleeping under the bed should be the same as sleeping under a canopy. And it's explicit that it's possible. How can Shmuel say that you're allowed to sleep inside the kilo, inside this canopy, under this canopy in the sukkah? Answers the Gemara, Tirgum Shmuel, Bemito, Gavoya, Asara. when is the sleeping under a bed an issue? Only if the bed is 10 tefachim high. And as Shmuel said, that if the covering above the person's head is 10 tefachim high, then it's considered an entity of its own and it's possible. However, if it's a bed which is lower than 10 tefachim, as with the typical kilo that Shmuel is talking about, indeed there's no issue. Continues the Gemara. Yet another source. Toshema, Oisha Pires al Gabe Kinoifois Psula. We learned that if somebody puts a canopy over kinoifois, which is also a type, and this is actually our Mishnah, we saw in the Mishnah that if somebody spreads a sheet on top of a four-posted bed, psula, then it's possible. Shmuel says that a kilo, which has four posts with a canopy on top of it, you are allowed to sleep in the sukkah. So it seems to be the opposite to what it says in our Mishnah. Answers the Gemara, Hosam Nami, de Gvi Asara. Our Mishnah is talking about when the canopy is 10 tefachim high, and that's when it's an issue. Asks the Gemara, V'oloik toni hacha. We learnt in a Braisa, source number 4. Not that way, the Tani we learnt in a Braisa. Naklitin shnayim. If you have naklitin, which is a type of two-posted bed, V'kinoifois arba, or a four-posted bed with a sheet draped on top of it, Piris al gabi kinoifois, if you spread a sheet on top of a four-posted bed, similar to the kila, psula, it's parcel. Al gabi naklitin, if it's on top of the two-posted bed, kshera, it's kosher. And the Braisa adds in, ubilvad sheloyiyu naklitin gavoya min amita asara. When do we say that a two-posted bed with a canopy draped over it, coming to a point, it's draped over a single bar in the middle of the bed, when do we say it's kosher? Only when it's not 10 tefachim high. Michlal, what can we deduce from there? That if it's 10 tefachim high, then even the naklitin will be an issue. But we see that the Braisa, the whole Mishnah is talking about, kinoifois is the same situation as the naklitin. Naklitin is kosher when it's not 10 tefachim high. So the kinoifois are only going to be kosher when the kinoifois, afal pisha in gvoim asara, even when the kinoifois are not 10 tefachim high, it's still not allowed to be slept under in the sukkah. So according to this Braisa, it's against Shmuel. And don't say we're talking about that it's more than 10 tefachim. No, because the Braisa says explicitly that naklitin is mutter in that case because it's only two posts. There's no roofing on top of it. There's no horizontal roofing. And only when it's less than 10 tefachim high, the Braisa is talking about less than 10 tefachim. Answers the Gemara, Shani kinoifois dekvi. A new principle. Even that means when Shmuel says you're allowed to sleep under a kilo in the sukkah, that's when it's less than 10 tefachim high. If it's more than 10 tefachim high, it's an issue, as we've determined already. If it's less than 10 tefachim, it's okay, with one more condition, that it's not a permanent or fixed canopy. So a kilo is not permanent. The kinoifois that we're talking about is also four posts, but there it's more kavi, it's more fixed. And since it's fixed, even if it's less than 10 tefachim, it's going to be a problem. Source number 5, Vari sukkah al gabi sukkah. What about your typical case of one sukkah on top of the other? Dekvi, it's very fixed. It's not like a type of a kilo that you just put you cover it, you take off the cover, you move it here, you move it there. No, it's a sukkah built on top of another sukkah. It's fixed. Va'oma Shmuel, and Shmuel said explicitly, Kech Sheira, Kech Psula, that only if there's 10 tefachim between the schach of the lower sukkah and the schach of the higher sukkah, then we say it's sukkah tachas sukkah. But if it's less than 10 tefachim, even though it's fixed, it's not considered sukkah tachas sukkah, and it's kosher. So how is he going to differentiate between the sukkah tachas sukkah and the case of the kinoifois, where the Braisa says that even if it's less than 10 tefachim, if you're sleeping under the kinoifois, under the canopy of this four-posted bed, that it's possible. Answers the Gemara, Omri hosom de le mifsal sukkah ba'asara. Over there, the discussion of sukkah tachas sukkah is not to determine are you in the sukkah or are you under a separate entity. No, there is to determine is it got the status of sukkah tachas sukkah. Is the upper entity considered the sukkah that being there on top of the lower sukkah is reason to be possible? Over there you need a 10 tefachim, otherwise it's not considered a sukkah. Hacha, but the discussion here is not about whether the area is considered a sukkah, not considered a sukkah. Delishvuya oyala, all we're trying to determine here is are you sitting, is this entity that you're sleeping under or sitting in, is it considered a tent? An independent of the sukkah. And for that, botzer me'asara, nam mihava oyalo. Even if it's less than 10 tefachim high, it's not considered a sukkah. We don't want it to be, we don't need it to be considered a sukkah. We need it to be considered an oihel, a tent, an entity of its own in order to be posel. If it's fixed, like we saw by the kinoifos, even if it's less than 10 tfachim, it's called an oihel, and it's considered as if he's not in a sukkah, and that's why it's posel, even according to Shmuel. So that all that was discussing what Shmuel said, that one's allowed to sleep in a kila in the sukkah. Continues the Gemara, Omer of Tachlifa bar Avdimi Omer Shmuel. Another halacha, seemingly related halacha, also from Shmuel, Hayoshon Bekila Orum. And here we're talking about another halacha. Here we're talking about where if somebody, in order to say the Shema, then you're not allowed to be in the same room as, or in the same entity as something which is erva, something which is inappropriately exposed. So if a person's not wearing any clothes, then he cannot say Shema. However, if he's wearing a clothes, then even though under his clothes, then there's private parts there, that's okay. But being in a room is not considered clothed. And if you stick your head out of the door or out of the window, you can't say I'm being clothed by the room and my head is sticking out. No different to if I'm wearing a cloak, that I'm my private parts are being covered by my cloak and my head is sticking out. That's only if it's a cloth, not if it's a room. What's going to determine if my body is in a room and then, so to speak, even if my head is sticking out of the room, my head is so to speak, associated to the room where the rest of my body is, and it's an issue? And when do we say no? My head is sticking out of some clothes. So Shmuel said, Ayoshon bekila. If somebody's sleeping inside this kila, which is this four-posted bed with a canopy over it, orum, then moitzi roishay chutz lekila. He's allowed to put his head outside the bed, and v'koyer kriyashma, and he can read the Shema. And this seems to conform with what Shmuel said before, that the kila is not considered an oihel, it's not considered a tent, so to speak, a room on its own, and sticking your head out wouldn't help, because your body is not covered, and it doesn't matter where your head is, you cannot say the Shema. No, since it's not considered an oihel, then the draping of the kila is just considered like a clothing or bedding covering parts of the person, and then it's okay. And the head, as long as the head is sticking out and is not under the same covering as the private parts, it's okay. Asks the Gemara, Meisvei Hayoshon Bekila Orum Lo Yoytzi Roishay Chutz LeKila V'Yikra Krishma. We saw explicitly in the Brisa that if you're sleeping in one of these kila, in one of these four-posted beds with a canopy over, you cannot just stick your head out of the bed and say the Shema. Answers the Gemara, Hochab Mayaskinam Kusha Gavaya Asara, like we saw before, Shmuel agrees that if the canopy is 10 tfachim high, then it's considered an oihel. Once it's considered an oihel, it's not considered as clothing, as a covering. It's just considered a room where you're in. If your body is in a room, uncovered, the fact that your head is out of the room doesn't help. Hochanami Mistabra, logic dictates this way, Midiktani Sefer, because the end of that source where it says, the Hayoshan Bekila Orum Loyitziroi Shechutz Lekila, it says, Halamoze Doime, what's it compared to? Loimed Bebayis Orum, it's compared to somebody who's standing inside a home, inside a house, without clothes on. Shaloyitziroi Shechutz Lechaloin, that he cannot put his head out of the window, Vyikro Kriyashma, Shma Mino. So we see from there that a type of kila where you cannot stick your head out and say Shema is a type of kila which is compared to a bayis. If it's 10 tfachim high, then it's got the entity, it's called a house on its own, not considered a covering to certain parts of the body. If it's less than 10 tfachim, it's considered as a mere covering over the parts of the body that are inside the tent, inside the kila, and if the head is outside the kila, then it's mutter to say the Shema that way. And now the Gemara says, Ubayis Namyan, even a house proper, if you're in the house, you cannot stick your head out of the window, because since you're in the house, it's not considered you're covered by the house, it's considered as if you're in the house. Afal Pisha Ein Gavoya Asara. It's true that regarding the Kila, if it's 10 tfachim high, it's considered a room. Less than 10 tfachim, it's considered as a mere covering. However, with Bayis, that not. Afal Pisha Ein Gavoya Asara. Even if the home, the house, is not 10 tfachim high, given the kvia, since it's a fixed house, oihalahu, it's considered an entity, a tent on its own, and therefore it won't help to stick your head out of the house. Deloi gora mi kinoifa is no different to what we saw before. According to Shmuel, the kinoifa, which is a four-cornered bed with a canopy, which is more fixed than a regular kilo. And as we said over there, even if it's not 10 tefachim high, it's considered an oil on its own, and you cannot be yotze sukkah whilst underneath it. The same will apply to saying Shema, that in the kinoifos or in the bayis, that regarding saying Shema, they are considered as an oil, an entity of their own, even if they're not 10 tefachim, and it's not considered as a covering of the person. It's only regarding kilo, which is temporary. If it's 10 tefachim high, it's considered a house. If it's less than 10 tefachim high, it's considered a covering. And you can be yotze sukkah under it, and you can say Shema in such a situation if your head is sticking out of it. Lishna achirina, omri lo, omer Rav Yehuda mar Shmuel. The first version of Shmuel, we saw that Shmuel says one's allowed to sleep in the sukkah under a four-posted bed, a kilo, even though it's got a roofing, providing it's not 10 tefachim high. In this version it says, Mutar lishon bekilas chasanim. Kilas chasanim is talking about a two-posted bridal canopy, which is similar to the naklitin we mentioned before. And you're allowed to sleep in that besukkah in the sukkah, lefisha ein lo gag, because it doesn't have a tefach, horizontal roofing on top of it, because it's just a two-posted bed, and there's just a canopy draped over a single bar across the middle of the bed. Therefore, one's allowed to sleep under that in the sukkah. Afal pisha gavoya asara, even if it's above 10 tefachim, it's okay, it doesn't bother us. Asks the Gemara, Meisve, we learnt in a brisa, yoshon bekilo besukkah, if somebody sleeps in the sukkah in a kilo, in a four-posted bed, lo yotzei idei chivasa, he's not yotze. How can you say here that sleeping in this two-posted bed is okay? The reason over there, the kilo, you're not allowed to sleep under it, is because it's got a roofing, it's got a roof over it, a tefach wide, because it's a four-posted bed. But the kilas chasanim is just a two-posted bed, there's no roof, and therefore it's not considered that you're under a roofing, and therefore you can be under that in the sukkah. Toshema, naklitin shnaim. And we saw this before already, this Bryson, that if you've got a two-posted bed, the kinoifos arba, or a four-posted bed, piris al gabi kinoifos, if you spread a canopy over the four-posted bed, psula it's posel. Al gabi naklitin, kshera, if you put the canopy over the two-posted bed, kshera it's kosher, ubilvad sheloyu naklitin gavoya min amita sarot fachim. And we saw this before in the Braisa explicitly, that even the naklitin, which are just two-posted bed, if it's 10 tefachim high, you're not allowed to sleep under it in the sukkah. If the post on top where the canopy is draped over is 10 tefachim high, psula is posel, afal pi she'ein lo gag, even though it's a two-posted bed, which does not have a roof. And this seems to contradict what Shmuel said, that a two-posted bed, even if it's 10 tefachim high, you're allowed to sleep under it in the sukkah. Answers the Gemara, Shani Naklitin de Kavi. In the same way as we saw before, that the kinoifos were more kavua than the kilo, that even though a kilo, if it's less than 10 tefachim high, you're allowed to sleep in it in the sukkah, but kinoifos not. The same is going to be over here, that the kilas chasanim, you're allowed to sleep under it, even if it's 10 tefachim high. The naklitin, which is more kavua, if it's 10 tefachim high, then you're not allowed to sleep under it. Shani naklitin de kvi, asks the Gemara, I kvi lehever ke kinoifois. I don't understand. If you say that it's called kavua, it should be like kinoifois that we saw before, that even less than 10 tefachim, you should not be allowed to sleep under it in the sukkah. And here it seems that only that if it's above 10 tefachim and it's not kavua, you're allowed to, because there's no gag, there's no roof on it. If it's kavua, and it's 10 tefachim, then you're not allowed to sleep under it, even if it hasn't got a gag. If it's kavua, it should be even less than 10 tefachim, you shouldn't be allowed to sleep under it. Answers the Gemara, legabi kinoifos, loy kavi, legabi kilo kavi. It's less permanent than kinoifos, and therefore kinoifos, you're not allowed to sleep under it, even if it's less than 10 tefachim. Naklitin, you are allowed to sleep under it, even if it's less than 10 tefachim, even though it's somewhat kavua. But it's less kavua than kinoifos. But it's more kavua than the kilas chasanim. And therefore, the naklitin, if it's 10 tefachim high, you're not allowed to sleep under it. The kilas chasanim, even though it's more than 10 tefachim high, you're allowed to sleep under it. Continues the Gemara, Dorash Rabbe Bar Rav Huna, Mutar lishon bekilo, afal pi sheyesh lo gag, afal pi shegavoya asara. This is a third opinion, which is even more extreme than what we've seen till now, that you're allowed to sleep under this four-posted bed, even though it's got a roof, which means it's four posts, and even if it's higher than 10 tefachim, which is more stringent, which is even more lenient than the first opinion of Shmuel. Kaman, who would this be following? Answers the Gemara, Reb Yehuda. This is the following, a unique approach of Reb Yehuda. Do'omar lo'osi oyel aray u'mevatel oyel kva. If you have any temporary type of tent which is positioned inside a permanent structure, then we totally disregard the temporary tent. And the temporary tent cannot undermine and disregard the oyel keva, the permanent structure that he's in. And since he's in a sukkah, which is oyel kavua, then any oyel aray, even if it's a kilo, with the gag and ten tefachim, you can still be there in the sukkah. Ditnan, we learned in the Mishnah, Omer Reb Yehuda, Noyagin Oyinu Lishon Tachas Amitom Epnei Azkenim. We used to sleep under the bed in front of the elders, and we had no issue with that. But since the bed is an oyel aray, the sukkah is an oyel kva, there's no issue. So asks the Gemara, V'leima Alochek Reb Yehuda, why did Rabbi Bar Rav Huna have to say you're allowed to sleep in this type of canopy, and we have to assume that because he holds like Reb Yehuda? Just say, Rabbi Bar Rav Huna, say Halacha is like Reb Yehuda in that Mishnah, that oil ara is not mevatel oil kva. Says the Gemara, no. I omar Alochek Reb Yehuda. If Rabbi Bar Rav Huna would have just said that Halacha is like Reb Yehuda, have I may have thought Hanem mili mito, that's only regarding a bed. The purpose of a bed is to use the top of the bed, not under the bed. And therefore, if you're under the bed, we can disregard that oil aray. Aval kilo, I may have thought that a bed with a canopy over it, it's made to be used in, so to use the covering, a bed, the bed itself, which is covering the person under the bed itself wasn't made to cover something under the bed. Here, the canopy was made as a covering for somebody inside the bed, under the canopy. The canopy is there for the intentions of serving the person underneath the canopy. I may have thought in that case, even oil aray will be significant and will be mevatel oil kva, and if you're there in the sukkah under such a kilo, it will be posel. Kumash Malon, that's what Rabbi Bar Rav Huna was coming to impress on us. Talmud Rabbi Yehuda, that the reason that Rabbi Yehuda says that sleeping under the bed is okay is deloy osi ayel aray mevatel oil kva, is because he holds in principle that a temporary tent cannot disregard a more permanent one. Loish no mito, loish no kilo, it makes no difference if it's under a bed or in a canopy. In both cases, it's not considered as if you're out of the sukkah, you're in the sukkah, and according to Rabbi Bar Rav Huna, he can be in the sukkah, even though he's inside a kilo, with a roof and above 10 tefachim. And in the next shir, we're going to learn the next Mishnah.